talking about her one husband in real life, but many husbands
on
on
screen.
screen.
Yes. There was a time in the serial when I used to come to the set and ask, "Wahi hai ya badal gaya?" Because I think Tulsi's character had what, four different me's?
Yeah.
There was one who began the show and he never completed more than 2 days of shooting. I remember we did one sequence and there was a big hangama about that sequence and somebody called up Ekta and said, you know, you've got a very, very bad actress and this girl called Smriti Irani and you need to replace her and the boy is equally bad. And the boy happened to be some top-notch model and he walked up to me and he said, you know, you're wasting your time. This is a pathetic show to be a part of. Picked up his slippers and he left and I was like, oh God, he has that option. I don't, because I don't have a job. So, I mean, I had too many people floating in and out of Mihir's character.
Okay, so let's talk about this evolved husband of yours.
Very
how
evolved.
How did you two meet and how did you fall in love?
I don't remember. I tell you why, because I've known him forever.
How have you known him forever?
I've known him since what? I was 11 years old and
oh,
now I'm 34.
And at that time he was like, married to someone else.
No, when I knew him, he was not. Then he got married to someone else. And then I met him again. And so, I've known him forever, so I don't know when I met him.
He didn't break up with his ex-wife because of you. That was already
a popular. I had a journalist who called me one day when I got married. Share with me your, you know, personal details. And I was like, excuse me, I don't like talking about my life. I said, you know, I can write whatever I feel like. I said, you're most welcome to it. And I banged the phone down.
And he did.
And he did. And that's where it all started. But it started and it taught me a lot of things. Because I had certain colleagues and I would be sitting in the same house, in the same room with her. Colleagues calling her because she was a very big professional from the industry. And saying that, oh, you know, we sympathize with you and Smriti is such a pain. And she would say, yeah, thank you. And she would put the phone down and she would tell me that tomorrow morning you'd be absolutely calm and you will not blow a socket and you'll just go there and smile. And I'd be like, yes. And next morning I would go and meet the same colleague and say, namaste.
And pretend like nothing is happening.
Go back to the big boxing punch bag and then just give it a few punches and that's it.
And the punch bag is actually your husband Zubin
No, I have a real punch bag.
You have a real punch bag?
Yes.
Oh, what fun. That's a great like stress buster.
It is.
Now, you're a Delhi girl.
Yeah.
And I've discovered also that even though you lived in South Delhi, you don't consider yourself a South Delhi girl. And you actually consider yourself the most uncool.
I am.
Why? Why do you say this?
Because A, coolness has to be defined for me. B, if it's defined, then I'm definitely out of that dictionary. And
but if coolness has to be defined, you can define it however you want, no?
No. Coolness is not defined by me. Not that it matters to me. But at the end of the day, I think it. Even my sisters tell me. They said, intellectual kaam karwana ho, kuch likhwana ho, ghar mein kaam karwana ho, sabzi khareedni ho, bhashan dena ho, Smriti, theek hai. Page 3 party mein jana ho, Smriti, please, don't.
But it doesn't
don't
interest
try.
You either, right?
It doesn't interest me. Some people have told me that, you know, it's a big disadvantage that you don't do it. And I'm like, yeah, do you think so? But I am still uncomfortable. I'm uncomfortable. I'm comfortable in a crowd of 10,000 people giving speeches, but I'm uncomfortable in a Page 3 setup.